In this Google Classroom tutorial, I'm going to be showing you how you can make video conferences using the Google Classroom. So let's begin. You're already inside your class in your Google Classroom, and if you click on Classwork, you won't find it on Stream or anywhere else. You have to be on Classwork. Select Google Calendar. Once you're inside the Google Calendar, there's a couple things you want to be aware of. You might have multiple calendars. Make sure you only have your class selected that you want, the people selected that you want to be a part of the conference. So for this purposes, it's my class. If I wanted to include my teaching partner's class, I could select that one. There's other calendars where people, here's the staff for my school. I can invite them that way. And then you'll go to the date that you want. This is in the day view. Let's select the month view. Find the date that you want. Well, let's set one up for Monday. I'm going to call this Monday session. You can call it whatever you want. And if you look here, you can add the time to it. So clicking on that, you can either type in the time or you can scroll around to the time that you want. We'll start it at 11. And let's say we're going to go for 2 hours. You can make all of that yours. You can also add additional guests by email if you wanted to. But before you press save, click on Add Conferencing. That's going to create a Hangout for you. That's what Google calls a Hangout. That's the room that everybody's going to be in. And then if you select that, it will take you to what it's going to look like. Oh, look, I'm there and I'm down there. That's kind of weird. There's two of me. This will show you once your conference is going, this is what it'll look like. It'll tell you who else is here and such like that. Okay, that's what it's going to look like. But what it did is it created a link for you on this. Now you can press save. And then if you select the event, you will see that people can join by phone. When they get the message or when they click on here, if their computer doesn't have video or audio options, they can join by phone, either by dialing in or it'll give them an option for they can give their phone number where Google will call them and give them this pin to join that. And then if you click on the little pencil to edit the event, there's some guest permissions you can do. You can allow your guests to modify the event, how long it's going to be, and all sorts of things. You don't want to do that. They can add things unless you want them to. Since I'm a teacher teaching fourth graders, I don't want to do that. I'm also not going to let them invite others. I don't want them to get emails to some of their friends who aren't in our school or our class. And I'll go ahead and let them see the guest list for now to see who's there. I'm going to put a notification on here that will give everybody who's been invited 15 minutes of time. And you can add another one if you wanted to. You could do it a day ahead, whatever. You can add as many notifications as you want. It's going to mark me as being busy, so that's okay. And then if I wanted to, I could say something about the description or something like that. Okay. Then you press save, and you're all set. If that's all you want, you're done. Here's a few other things that I want to point out to you in the edit section. The edit. And you'll notice here, you can have it repeat. So if you're doing it the same time every day, you can do it daily. You can do it every weekday. There's a custom way, just like any calendar event. You can make it repeat over and over again. And the other thing I wanted to show you was more actions. If you do it from the editing window, it's underneath more actions. Okay. This is the same as if you were to click on it and click on these options, you get the same options. But one of them is to publish the event. So if you want to put a link on your website, you can copy that in an email you give people, or if you actually want to put it in your website, embed it into your HTML code, you can copy that there. Okay, so those are other ways of inviting people. All right, enjoy your meeting.